Hey guys! So today I'm going to tell you guys about my little experience at Wondercon. This was my second time going to Wondercon and it was my second con altogether. I've only been to last year's Wondercon and this year's Wondercon. But I did get a bunch of stuff there and I got to see a lot of people and got to see some really cool movie trailers and see my favorite show and I got to see my friends, which was all very cool. So I'm going to kind of tell you guys about it. So first I'm going to show you guys what I bought, because I bought a lot of stuff. First, I bought some comics. I got six comics all together, but two of them have been misplaced and we can't find them at the moment. I think I might have left them at my mom's house. I'm not entirely sure. But the first two I got was Orphan Black 1 and 2. So it has Sarah and Beth, or Sarah being Beth, and Helena. So I haven't read them yet, but I love the show, so I'm curious to see how the comics are. The next one I got was Hawkeye. It has Hawkeye issues 1-5 and Young Avengers presents issue number 6. So it's all them together. I've already read it, but I wanted to get it because I love it. And I have a couple of the other ones. So now I have the first 5. The last one I got was iZombie. If you haven't seen it yet, it's a really good show, but it's based off a comic. And so I got the comic, and it has issues. How many issues does it have? Okay, I think it's just one issue. I think it's just a graphic novel, which is cool. It's really good. I've read just a few pages of it so far. Still got many to go, but it's very good. Watch the show. It's really cute. I'm not a big zombie fan. They definitely take kind of a warm bodies take to it. It's instead of zombies running after you for brains, it's kind of like a zombie trying to continue living a normal life while also eating brains. The other two I got was the Batgirl. The theme was Batgirl this year. Last year it was Wonder Woman. So they had Batgirl comics, so I got that one, and I think it was issue 40. It was pretty good. I read it. And then I also got Harley Quinn. It was cool because the cover was sideways, but you read it normally. It was really good. Harley Quinn is one of my favorite DC characters. I'm not a big DC fan, much more into Marvel, but I do like the female characters on DC. Batgirl, Ivy, Harley Quinn, definitely like Wonder Woman. I haven't really gotten into her as much as I have like with Harley Quinn and Batgirl so far, but they're all very good characters. So yeah, those are some of the comics I got. I got a bunch of shirts. So one of them is the official WonderCon shirt. Second one I got was an Orphan Black t-shirt. There you go. So it has all four of the girls, which is good. I liked it. The next one is obviously Harley Quinn, because she's just adorbs. And I really liked this one because she's holding a heart and I like hearts. And also it was the cutest one and less scandalous one. Next one is Avengers Age of Ultron t-shirt, and you know what I'm going to be wearing for when I go see it, which I'm seeing in IMAX. I'm so excited! So anyway, that's the shirt I'm going to be wearing. I also have a lunchbox. I didn't get it at Comic-Con. I got it in Pismo, and it's an Age of Ultron lunchbox. I will also be taking that with me because I need to eat. So the final one I got was from the, every year they have the Dr. Horrible sing-along blog. If you haven't watched it, it is on Netflix. It's really funny. It has Neil Patrick Harris, Nathan Fillon, and the amazing Felicia Day. So, anyway, I got this there. It's directed by Joss Whedon, and so is Buffy the Vampire Slayer, so they were giving us some Buffy shirts, and I bought one, because, I mean, who wouldn't want a good Buffy the Vampire Slayer shirt? So yeah, those are the shirts I got. I got some little knickknacks. There's a booth there called Fandom Flare, and they have these really cute buttons and little bracelets and like bows with buttons in them, and they have like giant buttons. So I spent a lot of time and money there. I got two bracelets. Alright, so there's Hawkeye and Black Widow and good old Captain America and Iron Man and Thor and the Hulk. And then I got a Supernatural one. anti-possession symbol. Crowley with his little hell demon dog. Sam, Dean. And I like this because it's like one picture. They're both standing by their car, the Impala, which is really funny. And then Castiel, I think that's the angel warding. Then I got some buttons. I have an Amity button because if I were in the Divergent world, I would be an Amity, obviously. These two, which is Dark Phoenix and Hawkeye. Because I was dressed up as Dark Phoenix, which was cool. So I found that. Where's my bag? So there's Loki, and it says, I do what I want. Some Jason and Freddy. Peggy Carter saying, I don't require your help. Bruce Campbell from Evil Dead 3 saying, this is my boomstick. And then Carry On My Wayward Son. Yeah, that's basically all I got. Like buying wise, I saw a lot of cool panels. I got to see Felicia Day, which was amazing. It was just her, and so she talked to us for an hour, and she did some Q&As, and I was gonna ask her a question, but I was kind of stuck between people, so I didn't want to get up because that would just be awkward. So I just didn't ask her anything. Then after that, we saw some movies. Every year they bring movies. Last year they had a lot more. Like, it was like hours and hours and hours. This year it was just 30 minutes. This year only Warner Brothers came. Last year Fox came and Warner Brothers came and I think Sony came. Like, a bunch of people came. Like, I got to see Luc Besson last year and The Maze Runner and like all that stuff. But this year I just saw two movies, and one was for the new movie coming out, San Andreas. They haven't released the commercial yet. I don't know when the commercial is supposed to be coming out, in a few weeks, I presume, because it comes out in a few months. So, I don't know. Is the commercial out? I don't think it's out. I don't know, but I know it's coming out this summer, and it looks absolutely terrifying, but it was really cool. The Rock's in it, and the chick from Percy Jackson, the girlfriend of Percy Jackson's in it. Anyway, so yeah, some good people are in it. It's about an earthquake in California, and I live in California. And earthquakes terrify me, so. What was the other movie we saw? Oh, Mad Max. Oh my god. Oh, am I excited for that. They showed us a couple scenes, and it looks amazing. If you like cars, and you like blowing things up, and you like apocalyptic movie setting, then you're gonna love Mad Max. And they have some really good cast members. They have what's his name? Tom Hardy is in it, who's takes my breath away. He's so attractive. Charlize Theron, I think I'm saying that right, is in it, and she's like bald, which is weird, which is cool. And then Nicholas Hoult is in it. But what's really funny, if you haven't seen the commercial, go look it up. I will wait. You can pause and go look up the commercial. Okay, I presume all of you have now seen it. So what I find really funny in the commercial is that when it's telling the actor's name with like this like, boom, this is who's in it, boom, this is who's in it. So the two, Tom Hardy and Charlize Theron, look so serious and like, just, oh, they're so cool. And then it goes to Nicholas Hoult and he's just like, I don't know why, but every time I see the commercial, it just makes me giggle. Anyway, so I also got to see the Orphan Black panel, which was amazing because the cast was there. Last year they weren't there. Last year they just showed us the new episode for season 2 before it came out, or the night it came out. This year they did not show us the full episode because it doesn't come out until April 18th. So they just showed us a bunch of scenes and talked about their experience, and unfortunately Tatiana was not there, who plays the clones, and I was really hoping she was going to be there because I was actually cosplaying as Cosima, and so it was really cool that the cast was there, but I had wished Tatiana was there. But I will take what I can get, and I got to see some of my friends, and they were dressed up too, so I got to take some pictures, and I made some new friends. I always make new friends at Orphan Black. Like, last year I made friends with Jessica, who I'll put her YouTube in the link below so you guys can go check her out. She has a vlog too. And then my friend Eric. So I got to see them.
And then this year, we made I made two new friends. One of them was dressed up like Sarah, and the other was dressed up like Cosima. So now we're friends on Instagram, which is really cool. So yeah, that's always fun. If you haven't gotten into Orphan Black, go watch it. It is amazing. It's about clones, and I can't even explain to you what it is about. Seasons 1 and 2 are on DVD, and they're online too, I think. And so you guys can binge watch before season 3 comes out on April 18th. So go check that out. It's a really good show. What else did I go see? I went to like the Nerdist panels because I'm actually on the Nerdist website. Go onto the Nerdist website and there's like an article and it says the best cosplays I've seen or the best cosplays at Wondercon 2015, and there's like 20 of them, and I'm in there with my friend Jessica and her sister's baby, and they were all, and all three of us were dressed up, and it was so cool. So go check it out. Go like it. Comment below or like this video if you've seen it. But I also went to the movie review, the summer movie review panel, and it's a bunch of critics. Might I add that they were all guys. There were no girls on the panel, so they need to fix that. So they're all critics, and they're getting ready for the summer movies because they say that this year is probably going to be one of the best years of movies because we have Avengers coming out, we have Ant-Man coming out, we have Mad Max coming out, we just had Fast and Furious 7, I think that's what kind of is kicking off the summer, either that or Avengers is kicking it off. What else do we have coming out? We have a ton of things coming out this summer, so that's what they were talking about, right? And I was like totally chill with this until they started bashing on characters I like. Like, they started talking about, I think they bashed on Clint Barton, and he is my favorite superhero. Okay, some people might not say he's a superhero, but he's on the Avengers, so he's a superhero, so meh, go away. Anyway, they started bashing on him, and it made me really mad about it, and that it, like, they did that in the beginning of the panel, and it made me so angry. So I did not have a good panel. Like, I was so frustrated with that, and but it was a good panel. I mean, they did have some good, I enjoyed them, but I was also very frustrated with them because I'm very protective of the movies I like. Oh, speaking of ranting, tall people, I'm talking to you, tall people, specifically tall men who do not move. Okay, so one of the nights, I think it was Saturday night after Orphan Black, we had went to a podcast. And it was really cool. They were talking about movies and random stuff, and they were really funny. And it's late. I understand that you want to get comfortable. I also was trying to get comfortable. I'm in the third row of this very small room, and I somehow managed to sit behind this, like not behind, like he was like diagonal. Here am I, and then here's he, and then the panel, so you have to sit diagonal. He somehow sat in front of me. And at first I was like, chill, like, whatevs, you can just, he was leaning back, so I just sat forward on my knee. But then he started to move, and he started to move back and forth. He would move to his knee, and then he'd move back, which meant I had to move back and forth. And about halfway through this panel, I'm starting to get very irritated. I legitimately almost grabbed the back of his collar and, like, shook him, because I was getting so irritated. Oh my god, tall people, you need to, like, sit in the back, because I don't have time for your tallness to sit in front of me. Now, I am very short. I'm not that short. I'm 5'4 and a half, but I'm still short enough that I need to see, and he was blocking my view, and Aaron says that's silly because it was a podcast, so all I had to do was listen, but I wanted to watch. I like to watch people. That's why I'm there. I want to watch the panels. This guy was ruining it. And then I don't even get to finish this part, this story, because it gets better. Guess who's, like, down, like, four rooms from us? The same freaking guy. Like, literally, we were going to Denny's, and I saw him, and I recognized him, because I knew the back of his head very well, because it kept getting in my vision. And he had these really long sideburns, and he's, like, a big guy. And I immediately recognized him, and I was like, oh, my God. I wanted to egg his door so bad because I was so pissed off with him. And he was staying in the same hotel on the same floor, just four doors down. he irritated me. He made me so mad that he just would not, why? Why can't you just sit in the back? Go sit in the back. You don't need to be up in the front. Let the short people be in the front. And I say this while the person who was at Comic-Con with me was also tall, but she's considerate. She moves out of the way. Like, she won't, like, sit in front of short people. Like, we'll switch spots if we have to so then the short person can see. And he was not considerate. He did not care the fact that I was flipping out behind him. And I didn't say anything. I could have, but I didn't because I was tired and I was grumpy and I wanted food, so I didn't say anything. But God, was he annoying. Tall people, don't do that. If I find you and you're tall, I'm going to silently hate you. I'm not going to say anything, but I will silently hate you. And if glares could kill, I would kill you, but I can't. So don't do it. Ugh. All right, happier news. What else did I do? I did a lot. The last day was kind of boring. We got to see Dr. Horrible, which was fun. I got to see the Hobbit thing. I went to onetruering.net or something like that. And I followed them on Facebook, and I really wanted one of their shirts because it was super cute, and it said, it was their Wondercon shirt, and it said, have you ever wondered how to con a dragon, and it had smog around it, and it was really cute, and Wonder and Con were like this, and it was funny. But they had run out, and so I was very sad, but the guy was very apologetic and let me sit in a barrel and take pictures. There's a picture. I had a lot of fun. There wasn't really much after that. Saturday was the big day. That's when I saw most of the panels. But overall, it was a very fun experience. If you're ever in Anaheim, actually, they're moving it to Los Angeles. I don't know if you read this, but they are. Okay, so what happened with WonderCon was that it was up in San Francisco, but then the San Francisco Convention Center was going under, remodeling, so they moved WonderCon down to Anaheim. For like 4 years, and or like they're like staying down here for 4 years, and because WonderCon is like isn't a big con, but it is becoming one because it's kind of like the little sister of San Diego, and everyone wants to go to San Diego. I don't know why. San Diego to me is just a giant pit of nerdy, sweaty people shoulder to shoulder. I've never been, and I don't really want to go anyway. So WonderCon, going back to WonderCon, not San Diego. But now it's going to LA because it's much bigger, and I'm kind of really fingers crossed that they keep it there and then they like make like another like form of WonderCon up in San Francisco, so it can stay at those two places like Wizard World moves around. So I'm wondering if maybe WonderCon will move around like that and have two specific spots in California for us who don't want to go to San Diego or can't afford to go to San Diego. So yeah, that's interesting, and I think they're even actually thinking about bringing San Diego up to LA, because they're saying not the convention center, but the city itself is really small, and they don't have enough, like, when cause you have to imagine, like, all these people swarm into San Diego, but it's also in the middle of July, which is also when all the people swarm to go to SeaWorld, so they have a ton of people just swarming into their city and they don't have enough room. So I think they were talking about also bringing it up to LA Convention Center, which would be interesting. I don't know if I'd still go. I mean, it's a little closer to me, but, you know, I don't really want to be attacked by so many nerds. Ugh, so much people. So yeah, WonderCon was a lot of fun. If you're ever anywhere where you can get to a convention center and you like comics and you like movies and you like shows, go to one. It's a lot of fun. I cosplayed all 3 days. First day I did Vanellope from Wreck-It Ralph. The second day I did Cosima. And the third day I did Red Phoenix from X-Men 3. So it was really fun. I really enjoy cosplaying. Last year I did 2 cosplays, this year I did 3. I like when people recognize my cosplay. Like a lot of people, there was some friendly people who said my Red Phoenix costume was very, very cute and they liked it and they recognized it. And that's it. So I think I've talked WonderCon enough. And don't forget to give this video a big like. It always makes me feel good when I get some likes. And don't forget to subscribe. And comment below if you have any ideas what you would like to see for next week's video. I don't really have any plans for next week. And we'll see what next week takes us. Have a great day, and I'll see you guys next week. Mwah! Bye.